هذا هو الخطأ. So this is a mistake. إذا بين الركوع وبين الرفع يقول سمع الله لمن حمده.
So between or during getting up from the ركوع standing up during this time he says سمع الله لمن حمده.
نعم.
سمع الله لمن حمده.
الآن استقام هنا يقول ربنا ولك الحمد. ما حكم قول سمع الله لمن حمده وربنا ولك الحمد؟ هذه واجب من واجبات الصلاة. فقول سمع الله لمن حمده على الإمام والمنفرد واجب. وربنا ولك الحمد على الكل. على الجميع.
So
قول سمع الله لمن حمده واجبة على الإمام والمنفرد.
بسم الله.
وليس المؤتم الذي يصلي خلف الإمام. أما قول ربنا ولك الحمد يجب على الكل.
So once he has now stood straight up, he says ربنا ولك الحمد. So saying سمع الله لمن حمده. This is an obligation upon the imam and the person who is praying alone, but not upon the person who is behind the imam. So if you're praying in congregation, then you don't say Sami Allahu liman hamida. As for the statement Rabbana wa lakal hamd, then this is an obligation upon the imam, upon everybody, the imam, the person who is praying alone, and the person who is praying in congregation behind the imam.
ثم يزيد بما ورد.
And then a person can increase in terms of the remembrances that have been mentioned, that have been narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
لربي الحمد لربي الحمد لربي الحمد.
So you can say this three times.
طيبا مباركا فيه. نعم. طيب ثم بعد هذا يسجد.
So then after this, after doing all of this, he goes down into prostration as sujood.
أكثر ما يكون خطأ وخلل وقد يكون مبطل للصلاة في حال السجود.
So the biggest, the most errors or the biggest mistakes that take place is in the sujood, and this can often be an invalidation of the prayer.
يضع باطن أصابع الرجلين على الأرض.
So a person should place the bottom of his toes on the earth.
يرص عقبه يضمه.
And he places his ankles together.
يضع باطن الكفين على الأرض مع ضم الأصابع متجه بها للقبلة.
And then a person places his palms, the inside of his hands, on the earth with his fingers together facing the Qibla.
حذو الأذنين أو حذو المنكبين.
To the level of his ears or his shoulders.
يجافي بين أشياء ثلاثة. مجافاة مباعدة. يباعد بين العمود والصدر وبين البطن والفخذ وبين الفخذ والساق.
So a person
So
a person has to make space or make space between three things.
العضد والصدر. So الطيب.
So this is armpit, i.e. his arm and his body.
وبين البطن والفخذ.
And between his stomach and his legs or his thighs.
وبين الفخذ والساق.
And between the thighs at the back of the legs and the shin. I mean, there has to be space between all these three things.
هذا هو السجود الصحيح والله أعلم.
This is the correct prostration and Allah knows best.
ويحتاط من يصلي حتى لا تنكشف العورة من هنا.
And the person's praying has to now take care so that his awra, his private part, is at the back is not uncovered.
الآن نطبق الأخطاء.
So now we're going to make mention of the errors, show the errors.
يضع رجليه هكذا.
To place the feet like this.
أو إحدى رجليه على الأخرى.
Or one foot on top of another.
أو يرفع رجلين كلاهما.
Or he raises his feet above the ground.
أي نعم. أو يضم.
Or he
he prays without prostration without making the space between his body.
يعني هذا بدون مجافاة.
So you can see how his elbows and everything and his thighs are all together.
أو يفترش ذراعيه على الأرض كما يفترش السبع.
Oh, for example, he
يعني يضع المرفقين على الأرض.
Oh, he places his elbows and his forearms on the earth, on the ground.
يمتد كأنه نائم من شدة ما يمتد. قدم كمان. لا. السجود نفسه لكن يمتد جدا. أي هكذا يمتد جدا يعني.
Or a person he elongates his body so much as if he's lying down, he's made to sleep.
حتى لا يكون راكع يكون كأنه نائم.
As if he's sleeping and not prostrating.
يلا. أو بعد ما ننتهي طبق السجود.
طيب.
بعد ما ننتهي. أجلس الآن.
So now we're going to move on to the sitting.
ماذا يقول في سجوده؟
Sorry, what does he say whilst he's prostrating his sujood? What should he say? Pray under.
بقي ما يعرفه.
The rest of you don't know.
نعم. سبحان ربي الأعلى.
He has to say سبحان ربي الأعلى.
وهذا فيه إثبات العلو لله سبحانه وتعالى.
And in this is an affirmation of the علو of Allah, the fact that He is high.
نعم.
Oh God.
قال يا جارية أين الله؟ قالت في السماء.
So when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to the slave girl, where is Allah? She said, He's above the skies.
لابد أن يقول في سجوده مرة واحدة سبحان ربي الأعلى وجوبا.
So the person who is praying has to say سبحان ربي الأعلى in the prayer at least once, and this is the obligation once.
ويستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And he can increase in saying things in the prostration according to that which has been narrated by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وكذلك هنا في السجود السجود موضع للدعاء موضع ومظنة لإجابة الدعاء. لكن بماذا يدعو؟
So the prostration, the sujood. So the sujood, it is the place to make dua. But what should he make dua with or for?
فيدعو بماذا؟
So what does he supplicate with?
الأولى أن يدعو بما ورد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
The best thing is to supplicate according to the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
لأن أدعية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم جامعة مانع.
Because the supplications of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they're comprehensive, meaning that they might be short words, but they cover a lot of meanings.
مثال اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عني.
So an example of this is اللهم إنك عفو. Oh Allah, you are the one who pardons. You love تحب العفو. You love pardoning, so pardon me, forgive me.
فاعف عني في مال.
So forgive me in what? Pardon me in what?
في بدني.
In my body.
في مالي.
In my wealth.
في الدنيا.
In the world. Worldly life.
في القبر.
In the grave.
في الآخرة.
In the hereafter.
في ولدي.
My child.
في زوجي.
My wife.
تشمل خير الدنيا والآخرة.
So this includes the goodness of this world and the hereafter.
هل يصح أن يدعو باللغة الإنجليزية ممن لا يعرف اللغة العربية؟
Is it correct for a person to supplicate what is in the sujood in English and he doesn't know the Arabic language?
يصح.
It is correct.
بشرط.
But with one condition.
ألا يغير الأسماء الحسنى.
That he doesn't change the beautiful names of Allah.
يعني لا يصح أن يقول God.
So for example, it's not permissible for a person to call to Allah and say, Oh God.
ما يصح لأن God ليس من أسماء الله. بل هذا من الإلحاد في أسماء الله.
This isn't correct because God is not from the names of Allah. Rather, this is a deviation in calling Allah.
هل يصح أن يقول Oh my God?
So is it correct for a person to say, Oh my God?
لا ما يصح.
It's not correct.
هذا إلحاد في أسماء الله.
This is from the types of deviation when it comes to the names of Allah.
أسماء الله تحكى كما هي.
The names of Allah, they are said or pronounced as they are.
يعني تقول يا الله.
Meaning you say, Ya Allah.
ثم يدعو باللغة الإنجليزية. أعطينا دعاء باللغة.
So you can say, Ya Allah, and then you can make any supplication in the English language. So for example, I'm sure that young people say, Allah give me
Allah اغفر لي.
Like, oh Allah forgive me.
نعم. ولا يصح أن يقول
And it's not permission from Allah to say, oh God, forgive me. You have to say, oh Allah, forgive me.
مفهوم.
So is this understood?
فإذا سمعت أي إنسان يقول, oh my God, تقول لا, ما يصح.
So if you hear any person saying, oh my God, then you say to him, this isn't correct.
هم أرادوا الكفار.
The disbelievers, they wanted.
أرادوا أن يعلموا على الإسلام هذا الأمر.
The non-Muslims, the disbelievers, they want to teach this thing to the Muslims.
قال, oh my God.
So saying, oh my God.
Shit. Sorry. يعني دائما هم يعلموا الإنسان اللعن.
So the voice that
يعني هذه الألفاظ كلها أرادوا أن يعلموا على الإسلام هذه. Oh my God. Shit.
So the Shaykh is teaching you that how the non-Muslims, they get people used to saying these type of insults. Even sometimes you say it without thinking it's a swear word. So these are things you don't say. Because they, the disbelievers, they always say these things. And the Muslim and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the Muslim isn't somebody who insults.
إذن عندنا ألفاظ شركية وألفاظ منهي عنها.
So therefore we have words or phrases which involve shirk and phrases that are impermissible, haram.
وأراد الكفار أننا نأتي بها دائما خاصة عندما يغضب.
And the disbelievers, they want from us that we always say these things, especially when we become angry.
هو لا يقول هذا في المسجد صحيح. لكن عندما يغضب أحيانا يقول هذه الكلمة.
So a person wouldn't normally say this in the masjid. However, when he becomes angry, then he starts saying these words.
نعم. فماذا يصنع عند الغضب أخذنا مر معنا. إنه عند الغضب يقول إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. اللهم أجرني في مصيبتي وخلف لي خيرا منها.
So what should a person say when he becomes angry? The things that the Sheikh mentioned. There's no might or power except Allah. Oh Allah, forgive me, and so on and so forth.
سب الدهر. لعن الدهر.
It's not permissible for a person to insult time or to curse time.
هاي كيف تقول لعن الدهر؟ نعم.
الله أعلم.
هذا إشكال.
في بعض العبارات.
طيب. إذا.
شيخ في عبارة في الإنجليزية.
أيوه.
You know there's a phrase that you say, all my days. يا أيامي.
هذا هو نداء الدهر.
So الله أعلم, maybe this phrase, all my days, meaning يا أيامي, this may be some type of
على ما عليه هذا نداء الدهر ونداء الأيام سب الدهر وهذا اللعن.
So things like insulting time or days, this is what the people Jahiliya used to say.
طيب إذا يصح أن يدعو بغير اللغة العربية بشرط ألا يغير الأسماء الحسنى.
So therefore, in the prostration, the sujood, it's permissible for a person who doesn't know Arabic to make dua, to supplicate to Allah in a language other than Arabic, like English, with one condition. And that is that you only call Allah through His names, as they have been mentioned.
ثم بعد هذا.
And then after this.
أيضا يعني من الكلمات التي يعني أنا هذا المعرف. يعني كثرت السب واللعن ويعني القذف بالزنا وبكذا. نعم.
So, Sheikh, according to what I know, what often takes place is swear words all the time, insulting, you know, accusing people of things.